Hey, welcome to the warehouse.
Hello, my name is David, and this is
Grayson.
We're part of the team over here. We are kind of what we call BDS2, is what it is. It's the second showroom, but it really is a retail warehouse here. Things that we have around here, things that you bring in for us, and things that the salvage dogs bring in for us.
That's right. So we're kind of like the first stop for all things salvage here. So a lot of folks have seen our show. We go out in the field and we salvage buildings, and then we come back with the salvage, and this is where we all unload the truck together. So it comes off the truck, we do all the weights and measurements, photographing, begin the research process, and hopefully get it online, and maybe even eventually to our showroom. Originally, we got this building about 3 years ago, maybe, as a warehouse to store things. We've kept our multiples here, things like flooring and paneling that take up a lot of room in our showroom. We would have a sample board over at BDS1, as we've been calling it. And then over here at our warehouse is where we would store all of the wood, a lot of lumber, multiples, and things like that. And over the years, we've just kind of accumulated so much, and we just decided to open up this to the public. The warehouse, we've estimated it at about 25,000 square feet, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Indeed.
Inside?
Outside, I don't know, maybe an acre and a half. A lot of woodwork that we have is located inside, but outside, and a lot of stonework, a lot of our wrought iron railing that has been imported everywhere from Egypt or from around the world. It's a couple of hoarders that got out of control. That's the only way I can describe it over here. That's all just. But you know, we do have them under control because we're trying to take tabs on a lot of the inventory that comes in. We've got a variety of different things. Things come in every day now. We don't know what's arriving. Sometimes when it arrives, we don't even know what it is. But that's what we do. We research over here.
That's true. So some of the cool stuff that we've got on the inside, a lot of stained glass pieces, entryways that come out of houses that are happening next to us right here, bowling alley flooring, all flooring that we've ever salvaged, a lot of paneling.
Theater seats that we have around here too, a lot of doors.
Not many left, yeah.
It's true, we've gone through some of those.
And then moving along outside, we've got some really cool stainless steel brewery equipment.
The best way to describe it is a little bit of pipes. It was a disassembled brewery and their spare parts when
in
they
Germany.
Put it back together. You know, sometimes that happens when you take your car to the mechanic. They do those things. So we get extra parts laying around here.
Yeah.
So you can have some of those too.
Yeah, great for projects. Also outside, we've got cast iron fire pits.
We
do. A lot of those kettles.
Mm-hmm. Mike goes around lots of times, or he gets phone calls. Who knows where those phone calls come from? But we did score some wrought iron railings, some transoms, and over 600 of them that have come from actually Egypt. Some of them date back 100 to 200 years old, and they are a bit rustic. We're just starting to process them. This is what happens. We bring them in. Grayson steps forward, kind of, we start to weigh these things, and she is the team leader. She starts
we
to weigh
We inventory every single one.
Every item. We research the history of this is what we want to do. We want to find out about it.
Mm-hmm.
Every little bit that we can find out about it, because that's what brings not only value, but a lot of the history with it. It's just part of the story that we have.
Sure, sure. And segueing back to Mike and the weird things he brings in, we got an airplane recently.
I heard that. I haven't seen it. Tell me about this.
Another airplane.
Mm-hmm.
The research actually hasn't been done yet, but we do know that it is a Duke Beechcraft.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know the year, but it's just a fuselage, and it's been cut into two pieces, the tail section and then the front section. So, to be determined what we're going to do with it.
Could get creative with that one, that's for sure.
Yeah. We've got some light fixtures here as well.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some corrugated chicken wire glass in amber and clear.
Where did we score that from? Where did he find all that stuff?
It was a railroad building, like a repair building in Clifton Forge, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
Soon to be seen on one of the episodes in season 8. So another cool thing about the warehouse is you'll get to see some things before they air, or you might see things from the past that we've salvaged that you recognize from our show. So how do we get here, Maui?
Well, you know, there's different ways, of course, but if you're coming from Black Dog, the showroom, you just go across Memorial Bridge, the first right. So what you do, you just go down two blocks. It's going to be about a mile. You'll see a ballpark on the left-hand side. The name of the street is Ashlawn, 629 Ashlawn. As soon as you turn the corner, you'll see the sign.
Big blue warehouse with our sign on it hanging on the front.
Park on the street, come in the walking entrance. Don't try to drive in the yard. You might want to stay on the street. This is an active warehouse. That's
mm-hmm.
exactly what it is. We are open for retail, but really it's just a warehouse.
Yeah, I've been thinking of it as like a picker's paradise. This is kind of how Mike and Robert started. You know, it's a bunch of salvage. There's people working, so just be aware, but we're also here to help you, and we want you to come and hang out with us and shop around.
Indeed.
Well, folks, I mean, that's pretty much the basics there. I think we've covered it as best as we can. You're just going to have to come and check it out yourself.